My name is Ryan Young, project manager for CJ Moyna Sons and Rapid Innovation. CJ Moyna Sons was started over 75 years ago. It's an earth moving company. We do a lot of heavy civil earth moving, usually highway projects or mass excavation projects. Within that span of things, we formed a couple of sister companies. Mobile Track Solutions manufactures construction grade equipment to support that industry.
My name is Patrick Palmersheim. I'm the systems administrator for CJ Moyna Sons. Here at CJ Moyna Sons, we have a legacy center that helps preserve a lot of Caterpillar's history and showcases a lot of earth moving throughout the years, coming from horses up to diesel-driven dozers and other equipment that we have. From the early 1900s up to about 1940, everything for Holt, Best, and Caterpillar. We use 3D printing with it to restore some parts that are pretty much impossible to find anymore, using 3D scanning and reverse engineering to make sure or to bring parts back to what we can do with them and put them back on pieces for display.
The company's ever expanding, always growing. Seems like we're always innovating in about 20 different directions at one time. During the pandemic, during COVID, we ran into a lot of supply chain issues, and that kind of spurred the conversation of what if we made our own parts and what can we make ourselves? So that kind of challenged us to look at what we're doing currently, what we can do to support not only Mobile Track Solutions in the manufacturing realm, but also CJ Moyna & Sons on the construction side and any of our other entities, what we can do differently there. And that's kind of what led us into the additive manufacturing space. Through the process of looking at the different printer manufacturers, BigRep stuck out just because the sheer size of the printer and then also the components that went into it. When we were looking at the gantries and the parts and pieces that go into it, it just seemed like a company that actually put a lot of thought into the detail on that. They're all top shelf components that go into that. Getting it set up and getting it up and running, you know, there's a learning curve like there is with any other machine, but once we got that kind of dialed in and got a couple little tweaks and tunes taken care of there, it's been kind of a rock solid machine for us.
Working with the BigRep Pro has been really nice, working with Kevin up at X-Build and some of the engineers from Boston over there. The machine is really well built. The gantries, the motors, the extruders and everything like that have been really nice to work with compared to some of the other smaller hobby machines that some of us started with. The engineering team has been really good. Some of the engineers over at Boston helping us out fixing issues that we did have. They're small, but they did help us fix them.
Use it for a fair amount of rapid prototyping, so things that support Mobile Track Solutions on some of their endeavors, test fitment pieces, mock-ups. Some of the pieces are functional dash parts for their production pieces. We use them on the antique restoration side of things, not only for cast masters, but also for some of the pieces that actually come into the Legacy Center here. We have made some pieces that will get painted and be on that final finished piece. Just part supply, just having the availability of some of those things. In the R&D side of things, it's immensely helpful to be able to print functional dash pieces in a couple of days versus going an injection molding process that could take weeks, if not months. You know, the ability to just kind of pivot, get it made, get it done. You know, 2 or 3 days times, you can have a large functional piece ready to rock and roll. Go-to material we use on the Pro is the Pro HT. That material has been very versatile for us. We've done a little bit with TPU, but Pro HT is kind of our go-to. Even on the cast masters and things like that, it's just a good material on that machine. I guess the finish detail is a good thing, and then accuracy is going to be another big part of that. We want to make sure that if we're doing a test fitment or we're doing a proof of concept, that the part is actually to scale and it fits as it needs to. Which we've been very successful with the BigRep printer. On a few of these pieces, we've done some post-processing, especially the ones that get painted and put on other parts. But a lot of times the parts are in good shape when they come off the print.
Overall, working with BigRep and X-Build has been a really good pleasure. They've had a really good team, and it's been a really great experience.
BigRep has had a tremendous impact in the way that we're manufacturing and the way we're looking towards the future of manufacturing. Just the ability to support the other entities, manufacture those parts and kind of change the way that they're engineering those parts. It's been interesting to see that shift where we're starting to see the engineering department at the other companies kind of understand how to make for additive manufacturing and how to build those parts for the print. I think it's only going to continue to improve and grow. We're already seeing all the different materials and things that can be done, different processes. I can see in another 10 or 15 years, 25, 30% of the parts are going to be 3D printed.